This is Ruksa Silvana, our community of around 400 houses. Located at the outskirts in the east of Bangalore, this area is surrounded with green, but now development has gathered pace. I started 4 years back taking pictures of birds. This video is about the birds I have spotted and managed to photograph. Any guesses as to how many varieties of bird are there in a 2 km radius to Ruksa? I have spotted more than 120. And in this video, I am introducing you to over 110 birds I have managed to photograph. Let me start with a disclaimer. I am no expert in birds, so it's possible that I may be identifying some birds incorrectly. So please bear with me on that. But the idea of this video is to showcase the diversity of the nature around us. All these pictures are taken by me and taken around Ruksa. This is the equipment I used to take these pictures. This is no DSLR. This is Nikon L840, a simple function camera which has been part of my weekend walks. So let's get started with some of the common birds which we commonly see in our campus. Let's start with the most common name that will come to our mind when we say common birds, the crow. There are two types of crows, the jungle crow and the house crow. It's strange that in Ruksa we see more of the jungle crow. I've not managed to get a good picture of the house crow in Ruksa, although I've spotted them rarely. The difference between the two is in coloration. The house crow will have the neck parts and the belly grey than black. More than the crows, the population of the common pigeon has been increasing in our community. I'm sure nobody misses spotting them. Talking about spots, the spotted dove is next in line. They are in plenty in our community. Every day morning, if you listen carefully, you will hear the melodies. Loud and clear will be that of the koel. The male koel is a glistening violet black, and the females are the spotted ones. These are a common sight to those who do their morning work. You will find the bulbuls in your garden trees often. The most common one is the red whiskered. This one is distinguishable with the red mark in the face and a very prominent spike in the head. The other bulbul, which is common in our campus, is the red vented one. Both of them feed on insects and caterpillars from the plants in our garden. They both have some melodious notes. But one of the best melodies is produced by the magpie robin. They do produce a number of tunes and variations in their call. Another black and white singer in our community is the white-browed wagtail. When you spot one, you will know why they are called wagtails. They also have some very smooth notes. Another black and white bird which has a feeble yet very sweet voice is the great tit. Active bird. I have mostly seen them as single bird in Ruksa. The drongo is a swift flying avian. There are the black and the ashy drongos in and around Ruksa. It's the black drongo you will spot often in the campus. The split in their tail is the clear distinction for them. They have two distinct calls. They have a chattering call and a more pleasant call. I think it's during their fights they do the chattering call. I'll now call upon the visitors who come to your garden seeking nectar. The purple sunbird is the common one you will spot in your garden. The male is the one which has this metallic purple color. But they have this full metallic color only for some part of the year. The full purple fades off and it comes back every season. The purple rumped sunbird is another variety of the sunbird found in your garden. You can make out the distinction by looking at their colors in the head and the neck. It's very mesmerizing to view these colors when it reflects light. The next bird is the smallest bird. The pale-billed flower pecker is a tiny bird that feeds on nectar and berries. You generally see them in Pruksha in berry-bearing trees. Another bird, the small bird that roams in your garden, is the Asheprenia. Although a small one, it can be a noisy one. I've also spotted their nest in my garden. Talking of noise, there is a gang that can be seen moving, chatting loudly. These are the babblers. I've never seen them silent. Both in the mornings and the evenings, you can see them in small groups in the open spaces. Seen them preying on the grasshoppers. Noisy group they are. But the bird that has the most variety of the calls is the myna. You can see two types of myna inside Pruksha. The common myna is the one with the yellow patch around its eye. I always see the jungle myna in a furious look. These blue-eyed ones always come across in my photographs in an angry look. What you heard is the call of the white-cheeked barbet. You hear them on a daily basis. It's very loud and distinct. It's difficult to spot them inside the foliage, as you can see from the photograph how well camouflaged they are. Doesn't this beautiful bird sound similar to a coppersmith striking metal with a hammer? Oh, and hence they are called coppersmith barbets. They are also called crimson-breasted barbet, as you can see the color in there, the crimson color. Both these barbets, with their strong beak, creates holes in the tree trunks to make their nest. I've heard people call them parrots, but these are rose-ringed parakeets. Just look at any dried coconut tree trunk in your vicinity, you'll find them nesting there. It's fascinating to observe them while they eat, the way they pluck the fruits or nuts, hold them in their leg. It's very similar to we using our hands to feed into our mouth. Another green beauty is the green bee eater. They catch bees and dragonflies in their flight, a very sporty bird. The pointed tail is one of the distinguishing features. Although I have spotted another variety of bee eater, this is the common one we see all around the year in Pruksha. They are generally called sparrows, but the bird you see in the picture is scaly-breasted munia, common in our campus and nests in our garden. Or it can also nest in the exhaust window panes, which are not frequented. The silver bill is more found in open spaces, and they can be seen mingled with other groups of munias. The tricolored munia is seen less compared to the earlier two, but I do spot them near the cricket nets once in a while. They are large, crow-like, with a long tail and coppery brown wings. These are cockles. I have read that there are two varieties of this in Bangalore, but I have not been able to distinguish them. It's usually seen hopping around the ground or between tree branches. In spite of their large wings, the cockle is a poor flyer. These birds in Hindi are sometimes referred to as Bharadwaj Pakshi. It is believed to be the reincarnation of Lord Vishnu. It is a common tradition to fold hands and bow in reference whenever one spots this bird. Another member of the crow family is the tree pie. The rufous tree pie, which you are seeing here, is usually seen in the mornings inside Pruksha. It's long-tailed and has loud musical calls, making it very conspicuous. The birds you saw in flight are barn swallows. The swallows visit Pruksha during winter. It's a little difficult to distinguish them, but here I present three different ones I have managed to identify: the barn swallow, the streak-throated, and the red-drummed. The spotted owlet is a small owl, a common resident of Pruksha, usually spotted in the early hours of the morning. They can be very noisy on some mornings. They roost in small groups in the hollows of the trees around Pruksha. There are a number of warblers, but I have not been successful in distinguishing them. This, I think, is a reed warbler. Now I move to some more birds which I have photographed inside Pruksha, but these are not the ones I have encountered commonly. I spotted them once or twice. The Indian white eye is one of those. I have spotted them on the gooseberry trees picking on insects. The Iora is another one, a very beautiful yellow bird which I have spotted a couple of times in the trees around the cricket nets. The Lowton sunbird is distinguishable with a longer and curved beak and a small crimson coloration. But compared to other sunbirds, I have spotted them less. A very colorful small bird is the minivet. This I have spotted near our gate. This is the male in the picture. Although I spotted the female, which is not as colorful, I now managed to get a picture. It's the other way around when it comes to the blue rock thrush. The male of this blue rock thrush is blue in color. I have managed to get the picture of the female, but never of the male. The next two birds I have spotted are on the tree inside GR Sun Villa, but very close to our sewage treatment plant: the white-naped woodpecker and the common tailor bird. I managed to spot the tailor bird a couple of times, but now managed a better picture. Let me take you outside Pruksha. Just about a kilometer is Hoskote Lake. It was much more pristine 4 years back. The development is already impacting the lake, but the lake still attracts birds. The range in my camera has been challenging to identify and spot birds in long distance, so you might find some of the pictures not that clear. Let us start with ducks. The Indian spot-billed duck is the most common one found in Hoskote Lake, and you will find them all through the year. I once spotted a parent with more than 9 offsprings. Here is a picture of it. Gagani is the next one. The male duck has a white striking patch just above the eyes. The northern pintail, of course, has a pin-shaped tail, but the brown head and a white patch in the neck distinguishes it. The northern shoveler is recognized by its glistening green head and a much flat beak. I do not know the reason, but the common teal reminds me of face painting of Maori tribe. It definitely has a painted face. Also managed to spot once the lesser whistling duck at the lake. Here is the pair. There are 4 types of herons that I have spotted at Hoskote Lake. Let's start with the pond heron, one of the most common birds, and I'm sure all of you have seen it. Next, the grey heron, a tall bird with grey back, white neck. This is followed by the purple heron, which is a large heron with rusty head and a streaky neck. I've seen both these herons catching fish at the lake. The black-crowned night heron is commonly known as the night heron, since this species prefers to catch their prey at night. I got this picture almost at dusk. The cattle egret gets its name from its habit of following cattle or other large animals. They can also be seen following the tractors to pick up any insects that it might flush. Egrets are beautiful and elegant birds to watch. Although it's easy to identify a bird as an egret, the confusion arises when you try to identify whether it is the little egret, intermediate one, or the great one. It tells us about their size. The painted stork is a definite sight when you visit the lake. Like the bird itself, you need to be patient to get a shot with the fish in its beak. The pelicans are the next ones, which you have a high probability of sight. These are the spot-billed pelicans, and these are the only type of pelicans I have spotted in this lake. Some of the other birds which are common sights are the purple swamphen, very distinct with their color. Common moorhens are also common. They are commonly known as swamphens as well. The relative to the moorhen is the coot. They can be seen in plenty in some seasons. There are three types of cormorants, the greater, the little, and the Indian. I have shown here the pictures of the greater and the little one. The little grebe is an interesting one. It dives into the water and will be resurfacing somewhere else. I found it difficult to get a shot at this bird. The lake plays host to two ibis, the black-headed ibis and the glossy ibis. Both of them occur in flocks. As can be seen, both have sickle-like beaks. I would love to get a close shot of the spoonbill. Never managed one yet. I have not spotted them often at the Hoskote Lake. The Asian open bill is also a less frequented visitor to the lake. The kingfishers are the next ones. We can spot three types of kingfisher near the lake. The white-throated is more frequently sighted. I only managed to spot the common kingfisher very less. Even when spotted, it has been at a distance. The pied kingfisher is the black and white kingfisher. You can see them flying at the same spot and then suddenly diving into the water. The two jacanas that are found are very different. The bronze-winged is the more regular sighted. The pheasant-tailed is spotted rarely. These pheasant-tailed jacanas are a delight to watch with their long tails. Their fights are also a unique sight. You can also see the white-breasted water hen throughout the year at the lake. In groups, you will also find the black-winged stilt. These groups sometimes we feel having a synchronized movements. I believe I have spotted two sandpipers at the lake, the wood sandpiper and the green sandpiper. They are usually camouflaged well, and as you walk near, you will hear the flutter of the wings, and suddenly they are gone. The next two birds, I've only spotted them once. The Indian stone curlew, or the thickney as it is called. They have a piercing yellow eye. The next one is also a bizarre looking one, the woolly-necked stork, or the white-necked stork. I've only spotted once, and never seen after this particular photograph. The lapwings are birds of the ground. They are incapable of perching. We have two types of lapwings near the lake. The most common one is the red-wattled lapwing. These are birds which gives the alarm calls and alert calls. And these are the first to alert all the birds of an intruder's presence. The yellow-wattled is endemic to Indian subcontinent. And most of the time, you find these lapwings in pair. I talked about the white-browed wagtail as a bird commonly found inside Pruksa. Another wagtail which can be seen near the lake is the yellow wagtail. Now let us look at some birds with talons. The most common one you can see Anytime you look up at the sky is the black kite. It is one of the birds that is best adapted to urban conditions. The Brahmini kite is a majestic bird and they can also be seen hovering above Pruksha, but you can sight them mostly near the lake. It's a sight to watch them fishing. One of the smaller members in this family is the Shikra. You can spot them either during the dawn or dusk at Pruksha. They come to catch bats. It's an interesting sight to see them catch the bats in their flight. Another majestic looking kite is the black winged or the black shouldered kite. I spotted them in seasons on the roads leading to the lake. They usually prey on rodents. As you walk around the lake, occasionally I have spotted the marsh harrier. The white patch in their head is the distinction for them. I have also seen them hunting on small ducklings. The greater spotted eagle was spotted only once, and that too accidentally. It was a long shot and I thought it was a black kite or a juvenile Brahmini kite. But later, when I was developing the picture, I spotted the difference. I had to check with some people who know better about these birds to identify it. I had not been able to get a good shot at the oriental honey buzzard in close. Here is the shot of the same bird in flight. There are a couple of other varieties of eagles I have spotted, but have not been in a position to get some good shots. Now, this last set of birds I am showcasing are the ones you will find in a kilometer radius of Pruksha. Starting with some cuckoos, the grey-bellied one can be spotted near the farmlands. I spotted some hepatic versions of the females in ginger-orangish colors. The common hawk cuckoo, or it is also known as brain fever bird, it resembles Shikra and even has a similar flight pattern. The Jacobin cuckoo or the pied crested cuckoo is considered as the bird which brings rains. That's because of the timing of their arrival in India. The large cuckoo shrike is a bird with a strong bill. I have spotted them in villages around, but now got a clear photograph. I have also not managed a good photo of the black-headed cuckoo shrike. It is always found inside the foliage of the trees. The shrikes are called the butchers among the birds. This cute bird impales its prey on the thorn of the trees. That sounds brutal. You can spot three varieties of shrike. The long-tailed one, I spotted them near the lake. The shrikes are territorial and you can see them in the same place often. The brown shrike can be seen near the open place outside our boundary wall near the big park. The bayback is a less frequented spotting, but can be seen in bushes around the lake. Dressed in a glossy black and a pale pink are the rosy starlings. These will be found in flocks and usually spotted in winter. The chestnut-tailed starling is another member of the starling family that you can see in this vicinity. The Brahmini minor or starling is another one, which you can see mingled with other starling flocks. I have seen them inside flocks of rosy starling. These are birds which are found very frequently outside Pruksha, but I have not spotted them much inside. The first one that comes to my mind is the pied bush chat. The male is black in color. The stone chat is another common one, which I find especially near the lake. The zitting cisticola is a kind of warbler and is found distributed in many places. House sparrows, once very common across Bangalore, is not a common sight anymore. But I do spot them still near houses in the villages around Pruksha. Ashy-crowned sparrow lark can be seen in the agricultural fields around the lake. The Indian bushlark is another bird very widely distributed all around our place. I find the red munias very interesting because of the red color. But this red color is not there throughout the year. They shed the color and it is only for one season they have this red color. They can be spotted around the lake very often. Plain prinia can be found in bushes and are a frequent sight during my walks. Compared to spotted dove, get to see the laughing dove less. They are called laughing dove because of their distinct vocalization that resembles a human laughter. Hoopoes. They are a delight to watch. The fanning of their crest is a beautiful sight. They can be sighted near the agricultural fields. The Indian roller is a seasonal visitor and I have spotted them mostly solitary. The display of the blues when they fly is a very beautiful sight. The Indian robin is another bird which has a sweet call. The male of this bird is bluish metallic black with a chestnut colored bottom. The best of the weavers, the Baya weaver, they build those beautiful hanging nests. I have spotted more than 40 nests in one tree near the lake. This olive-colored beauty is the white-browed bulbul, and like other bulbuls, they have a very nice call. As the name suggests, this large gray babbler makes some loud noise. They can be seen in the forest area beyond the lake. One of the loudest of the birds is the Grey Franklin. It has been very difficult to get close to the bird and hence all my pictures are of long shots. I spotted the Golden Oriole in the forest patches past the lake a couple of times. This yellow beauty is very secretive and hence it is difficult to spot. The Blue-tailed Bee-eater. The sighting of this is rare compared to the green bee-eater. I have only spotted them a couple of times in the lake. The leaf bird is another secretive and very well camouflaged bird. I spotted this a couple of times in the farmhouse next to Pruksa. The Asian paradise flycatcher. I managed to spot this once in the water catchment area of a village nearby. Yeah, the peacock or the Indian peafowl. This was spotted at the turning to the Nimbakaipura village. I could hear them during my morning walks from January 2020 till about June 2020. I'm not hearing them anymore. The last one I present is the hornbill. The first time I spotted, I couldn't get a picture. And when I came back and I sat at home, nobody believed me. But the sighting of this is no rarity. I spotted them a number of times and I managed many pictures. This is the grey hornbill. As I mentioned, there are many more I have spotted but not managed to get a picture, and there are many more I have not spotted. The journey for me continues. You can catch up on more of my photographs and information in my Facebook and Insta pages. The Facebook page is SJ My Nature and my Insta handle is SJ By Nature. I firmly believe you see what you seek. Just think about this, that this is just the birds around you. There are the flowers around you, the bees and insects around you, the reptiles around you, the sunrise, the sunset, the people. If we are conscious to our sights and sounds around us, we feel the life. Thank you for watching.